Security isn't just about fancy tools. It's about consistent habits that work. Hello, everyone. Welcome to my channel. My name is Alexandra. I'm a cybersecurity analyst who focuses on digital privacy protection and preventing identity theft. Today, I'm sharing the exact security system I use to protect my digital life. By the end of this video, you'll have a clear plan to fortify your digital presence against 90% of common threats. Before we continue, I need to address something critical. Most of you are wasting time and money on security tools you don't need while ignoring the real threats to your digital life. Why does it happen? Because you haven't identified your personal threat model. A threat model is simply this: who might target you and what do they want? Without knowing this, you're just throwing darts in the dark. That's why I created the personal threat model identification quiz. In just 7 minutes, you'll identify exactly who might target your information, understand what assets you need to protect, get a customized security plan that makes sense for your life, and stop wasting time on pointless security theater. The link is in the description. Take it now and let's get started. Step number one, authentication overhaul. First, let's fix the foundation, your passwords. The average person reuses passwords across 14 different services. That's like using the same key for your house, car, office, and safe. Here is exactly what to do today. Install a password manager. I personally recommend ProtonPass. Set up your master password. Combine 4 to 5 random words with numbers. Example, correct horse battery staple 42. Don't use this exact one. Store this master password physically on a piece of paper in a secure location. Don't keep it digitally. Generate unique passwords for every account. Passwords should be minimum 16 characters, including symbols, numbers, mixed case. But you don't need to do all that. Use Password Manager's generator tool. Start with your email, banking, and social media accounts. Schedule 30 minutes each day to change 5 to 10 passwords until all are unique. Next, set up two-factor authentication on critical accounts. Use an authenticator app like Aegis for Android or TOFU for iOS. Avoid SMS authentication when possible due to SIM swapping vulnerability. Save backup codes in your password manager and print it physically. For Google accounts, set up advanced protection if you're high risk. For maximum security, add a hardware key. You can choose UV key or Nitro key. Register at least 2 keys, one as a backup, and store backup key in a secure location, like a fireproof safe, ideally. Your immediate action item at this step, install a password manager today and change your email password first. Step number two, network security. Your home network is your castle's outer wall. Here's how to secure it properly. Update your router immediately. Find your router's IP address. It's on the back on the router. Login credentials are often on a sticker on the back of the router. Change the default admin password to something unique. Check for firmware updates and install them. And set a reminder to check for updates every 3 months. Next, configure proper Wi-Fi security. Use WPA3 if available, otherwise WPA2 or advanced encryption system. Create a strong Wi-Fi password, 20 plus characters. Disable Wi-Fi protection setup. It's a security weakness. Change your SSID to something neutral, not your name or address, and hide your SSID if you don't mind the minor connection inconvenience. Next step, segment your network. Create a separate guest network for visitors. Put your Internet of Things devices on their own network if possible. If your router supports VLANs, separate work and personal devices. Next, create connection rules. Treat all public Wi-Fi as compromised. Use your phone's hotspot instead of public Wi-Fi when possible. Always verify SSL certificates. Look for the lock icon. Use HTTPS only mode in your browsers. Your immediate action item in this step, log into your router today and update the firmware. Step number three, device hardening. Your devices need security checkups too. For computers, enable full disk encryption. For Windows, turn on BitLocker or VeraCrypt, which is a free alternative. For Mac, enable File Vault in System Preferences. For Linux, use Lux during installation or encrypt later with Crypt Setup. Save recovery keys in your password manager and physically print it. Next, create a proper update routine. Set operating system updates to automatic when possible. Schedule a monthly update day for everything else. Check for firmware updates for peripherals and never postpone security updates more than 24 hours. Next, install proper security tools. For Windows, Window Defender is actually good now, plus Malware Bytes are free. For Mac, Malware Bytes plus Little Snitch to monitor connections. For all platforms, try ransomware canaries. Consider application testing for high security needs. Next, set up robust backups. Follow the 3-1 rule. 3 total copies, 2 different media types, and 1 offsite. Locally, use an external drive with automatic backups like Time Machine or File History. In the cloud, encrypted backup services like Backblaze. Test recovery quarterly by actually restoring some files. For phones, perform a security audit for iOS phone and follow these settings. For Android, these are the settings. For both operating systems, remove unused apps monthly. Fewer apps mean fewer risk. Next, lock down access. Use a 6-digit PIN instead of patterns or biometrics for legal protection. Enable remote wipe capabilities. Set auto lock to 1 minute maximum and disable lock screen notifications for sensitive apps. Next, create security zones. These are work profiles for Android or focus modes on iOS with restricted access. Turn off services you don't need, like Bluetooth, location, NFC. Your immediate action item at this step, enable full encryption today if it's not already active. Step number 4, digital identity management. Your online accounts are your digital identity. Conduct a thorough account audit. Download your Google, Facebook data to see connected services. Check password manager for forgotten accounts. Use haveibeenpwned.com to find compromised accounts. And document every service in a secure spreadsheet. Next, delete unused accounts. Just delete me.xyz to find account deletion pages. For accounts you can't delete, use random garbage data. Take screenshots of deletion confirmations and contact support directly for stubborn accounts. Next, use email analysis for everything. You have simple login or anonymity. Create category-based analysis like shopping ad, social ad, finance ad. Use unique aliases for important services. Set up separate aliases for family members. How to spot a data breach if spam comes to a specific alias? You know that that company has compromised your data. Monitor your personal information. Set up Google Alerts for your name and email address. Check people search sites quarterly. Monitor your credit reports via free annual checks. And consider a credit freeze at all 3 bureaus. Your immediate action item at this step, sign up for simple login or anonymity today and change your most important accounts to use aliases. Step number 5, communication security. Secure your communications or accept that they are being monitored. Switch to encrypted messaging. Install Signal as your primary messenger. Verify security codes with important contacts in person. Use disappearing messages for sensitive conversation, maximum 24 hours. For maximum security, voice calls, no text, for truly sensitive matters. Next, secure your email. Create a Proton Mail account for sensitive communications. Learn how to use pretty good privacy for critical emails. Thunderbird has it built in. Never email sensitive documents. Use Signal or secure file transfer. And use email aliases as previously discussed. Next, be aware of metadata. Even with encryption, who you talk to and when is visible. Group several errands together to create noise in your patterns. Consider time zone differences when communicating internationally. And remember, volume and frequency of communication can reveal information. Next, create communication compartment. Use different email domains for different aspects of your life. Keep work and personal communication strictly separated. Consider a dedicated device for high-risk communication. Your immediate action item at this step, download Signal and convince your 3 most frequent contacts to use it. Step number 6, financial security practices. Your money deserves extra protection. Use virtual cards for all online shopping. Use Apple Pay or Google Wallet whenever possible. These solutions generate unique tokens for each payment, which means your actual card number is not shared with the merchant. While the transaction is not completely private from your bank, these systems provide a more secure method of protecting your card information from potential breaches. Create separate virtual cards for subscriptions and set spending limits on all cards. Use one-time cards for unfamiliar merchants. If you want to pay anonymously, use cash when possible. It offers privacy, but lacks the security features of digital payment methods. Next, set up robust banking alerts. Login notifications for all financial accounts. Transaction alerts for over a minimum amount. Change of address and new accounts alerts. Credit inquiry alerts through credit bureaus. How to do it? Find in your banking app under security or alerts section. Next, lock down your credit. Set up full credit freezes. Request full credit freezes at all three bureaus: Equifax, Experian, TransUnion. Create calendar reminders to temporarily unfreeze when needed, and add fraud alerts as an extra layer of protection. Next, create financial isolation. Use a dedicated device for financial transactions if possible. Create a separate email just for financial accounts. Consider a dedicated secure browser like Brave. Use a different password algorithm for financial accounts. And never access financial services on public Wi-Fi. Your immediate action item at this step: create separate virtual cards for subscriptions and add them to Apple Pay or Google Wallet. Step number 7, ongoing security maintenance. Security isn't set and forget. It requires maintenance. Schedule monthly security checkups. Create a recurring calendar event with a checklist. Check for software updates across all devices. Review account activity logs for anything unusual. Scan computers for malware. Review password manager for weak or reused passwords. And use your free security maintenance checklist linked in the description. Next, test your backup restoration process. Restore files from your backups quarterly. Verify both local and cloud backups work. Time how long restoration takes. Know this before an emergency. Rotate backup media if using physical storage. And document the restoration process step by step. Next step, run security drills with family members. Practice account recovery procedures, role-play social engineering attacks, test emergency access to password manager, review physical security of devices and documents, and update emergency contact information. Next, stay informed about new threats. Follow reputable security blogs. Krebson Security and Bruce Schneier are the veterans in the field. Focus on actionable information, not fear-mongering. And subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Your immediate action item at this step: set up a recurring monthly calendar invite for your security maintenance. These 7 steps form the security system that will help you start erasing your online footprint. They are practical, effective, and manageable. Perfect security doesn't exist, but these habits put you ahead of 95% of people online. Remember to start small. Implement 1 action item from each section this week. In the description below, I've included links to all the tools mentioned, plus my comprehensive security checklist. None of the tools or services mentioned are sponsored. All recommendations are based on personal research, hands-on testing, and independent evaluation. If you found this helpful, hit the subscribe button and notification bell. I'll see you next week. Until then, stay secure, stay vigilant, and don't let convenience overcome common sense.